ask everyone to rise as Florence Junior Senior High Band will play the national anthem.
Good evening, Husky Nation. I am Crystal Melendez, and we welcome you to Florence Junior High School's 2022 commencement ceremony. I am grateful for the wonderful opportunity with all of you here to celebrate our 50 graduates sitting before you today. I want to welcome parents, students, our community, Dr. Craig, all our new faculty, and the Board of Education as we are excited to celebrate the senior class of 2022. At this time, I would like our Florence Junior Senior High School staff to rise to graduates and the community to thank you for all your hard work with these students. Thank you, sir. Now, I would like to honor our military guests, past, present, or future, that have joined us today. Please stand and be acknowledged by your community. Thank you for your service. I also want to take a brief moment of silence to acknowledge our fallen soldiers who have lost their lives serving the greatest country in the world. We thank you for your service. Seniors, I want to start off by saying how proud we are of you. It takes courage who you really are. We stand here looking at all of you, and we can confidently say, after everything you have been through the past few years, you are prepared to go to the adult world and chase your dreams with a touch of madness. Reflecting back, your high school years have not been easy. In fact, they have been very, very difficult. There can be constant challenges, ups, downs, and surprises. You stared at adversity in the face and smiled with husky pride. Things like change, from a high school to a junior senior high, this was a physical change. This was a mental change. You saw two students and staff cultures combined, and entrusted me to be your principal and lead you. You have embraced this, and you have flourished. Now think back to your freshman. Many of you had no idea what you were going to do. Did you want to go down the traditional route, the CTE or college pathway? Did you want to join the military? We hope that your time with us has helped you take giant steps to move closer to the reality of what you want and need in your own personal journey. Fast forward to this year. You came into this year thinking it would be normal. Boy, were you wrong. We are still dealing with quarantines, wild conditions, and even life situations that were out of your control. And let's face it, at this point, you're ready to just move on to the next chapter of your life. I can remember talking to many of you in your college world, millennials pulling at the red. However, once again, you pushed through. Each one of you decided that you would not be defined by your circumstances, but go into everything with an attitude that you can control what you can control. You defied the odds, as well as we watched and saw you grow into young men and women sitting before us today. You took every moment as a blessing and enjoyed the ride. You even got annoyed with me as I preached, "Guys, remember to embrace the husky graduate profile." And I suck. I know you guys didn't kick that out. I know what I know you would say. Be self-aware, be bold and connected, and a learner for life. I get it, Melendrez. I see you guys smile, Melendrez, right now. Once again, I look at you proudly, because while you may have had all those challenging days, you still smiled, you gritted your teeth, and you exhibited husky pride. You did not take for granted how hard it was for you to get to graduation day. You made a decision to rally behind each other, have a positive attitude, and grind it out. You rose to the occasion to make your family, school, and community proud. Look at everyone around you right now. You learned, grew, adapted, and even did degree dance along the way. And yes, I saw you doing degree dance. We as adults want to acknowledge that you try not to worry about it. You only focus on getting to the finish because that's just who you are. No one here can tell you what path lies ahead of you, but you get to create and follow your own personal legend. I leave you with a few quotes. There is only one thing that makes a dream impossible to achieve: fear. Don't give it to your fears. If you do, you won't be able to think or talk to your heart. Everyone seems to have a clear idea of how other people should lead their lives, but none about his or her own. You are capable at any time in your life to do what you dream of. I say this every year, and I'll say it again. You are surrounded by many amazing people here, but as you get older, your circle gets smaller. Always embrace those who are willing to support your dreams because most won't. Remember to serve others and give back to your community. You represent yourself as well as your family. And lastly, when each day is the same as the next, it's because people fail to recognize the good things that happen in their lives. Every day, the sun will rise and set. Ladies and gentlemen of Husky Nation, on behalf of Florence Senior High School, let's give these seniors a big round of applause. At this time, I want to welcome you to sit to the stage our salutatorian, D.K. Redman.
the parents, families, and friends of the 2022 graduating class of Florence Junior Senior High School. More importantly, I would like to welcome and thank the students of the graduating class of 2022. These past 4 years have just been a fucking year at Florence High School with my fellow classmates and teachers. I wouldn't change it if I had a choice. These past 4 years, I've been football, basketball, and basketball. While doing sports, I made tons of new friends. I was also able to connect with the community thanks to my sports. Florence High School has made many students and individuals that are involved, and many more, and you have to thank Mr. Service for that. Without him, we would be lost. The graduating class of 2022 has been through the ups, downs, COVID, and most contentious presidential election as of our time. But through that, our class has become the strongest, most informed, and most detailed class of the all time. Again, welcome to Florence High School, and join me in giving a hand to the graduating class of 2022.
At this time, I'd like to introduce the choir who will be performed for good by Stephen Schwartz. Please welcome to the stage our senior choral duet, Mike Jericho and Austin Sims. Thank you.
Please welcome to the stage our commencement speaker, Mr. Warren G. Moody, who will be our commencement speaker.
They were calling me to talking about possibly being the speaker here tonight. I thought that was pretty amazing. But I said yes. And I knew there was work to do. You know, like I said, I grew up in a big family. And things weren't easy, especially at mealtime and bedtime. It's kind of like a war zone. I mean, being under 10 or 11, so, you know, I was always last, or close to that. But, you know, growing up in that family, with the parents I had, they taught us to work hard, make good choices, and try to move forward, help people when we can. In high school, I was in sports in high school and college, and made choices there. Made choices to work hard, because I played football and college in college. And that doesn't happen if you don't make the right choices. You have to work hard to get yourself in a place like that. And, you know, through high school and college, I had the opportunity to meet some people that I'm still connected to today, some of the best relationships, and Facebook has a little bit to do with that. But I've had a lot of positive and negative influences in my life, but I've made choices to not dwell on the negative and not allow that to keep me from trying to somebody excited. You know, I moved here and I made the best effort, I made a choice to try to be productive in the community. And because of that, I've met some pretty amazing people. These people have helped me to move along here. And I feel this is one of the years I've been in the town where I grew up. Florence is pretty amazing, and we have some pretty amazing people here. You know, I grew up in a pretty loving family, and everybody has a kind of family, but, you know, don't give up, because things can change. I mean, you have a choice to make your life different if you're not having a life. Make a choice to listen to a teacher who you admire. Talk to people that are in your life to try to help you move forward. And see other people you want to be like, because there are some pretty good people, especially here in this community. Some pretty amazing people. Just look through your eye and left, and I guarantee you, there's a pretty good chance you're going to see something. I know I have. When I look back at my life for the years since I graduated high school, there was some change in the world that I never dreamed I'd see in my lifetime. But you know, some of the changes are good, some of them are not so good. But you have a choice to make a difference. And you may choose to work at a restaurant and be a construction worker. You may go into the military. And some of you in this class tonight, there's a possibility that you could be a future president of the United States. There's a chance. There's always. Yeah. I'd vote for you. I mean, I had the opportunity to meet with the principal advisor here, and I got to tell you guys, there were 5 students in that group. 5 of the most well-prepared students, young adults, I've ever met in my life. Blew my mind. In fact, I told them I thought they were the ones that should be speaking here tonight. they've got it together. And I've got to say it, between the faculty and the staff here, and that faculty Florence trustees, you guys have done some pretty amazing work. I mean, we've seen some things here over the last 3 or 4 years that a lot of us have never been through anything like that. And you guys come out the way you have. I have no problem in the world stepping aside and leaving this world with you guys because you're pretty amazing.
Yeah.
Woo! You can be proud of yourself because you've earned it. I mean, you hear that a person's earned this and earned that, but to go through what you guys have over these last 2 years, and to come out of here graduating and being prepared for your future, for what you guys have, be proud of yourself because I should have been. And I hope the rest of you too here is proud of you as well. Thank you very much, and congratulations.
Thank you, Mr. Moody. Please welcome to the stage the valedictorian, Brandon Hall.
Submitted to my office, I have found the candidates before you.
have completed the requirements for graduation. I therefore certify that these 50 candidates for graduation have fully satisfied the requirements prescribed by Fremont Arkansas School District Board of Education, and shall be considered the Florence Junior High graduating class of 2022.
Thank you. biomedical engineering and biological medical engineering.
Thank you. Thank you.
And with that, it's now time to move your tassels from your right side to your left side.
You're welcome to the floor.